Hi everyone, it is Koto. We have a very hot summer day today, so I am watering my plants together with my little helper. I am also making some refreshing iced coffee. Now I am ready for editing the pictures that you sent me to edit in Lightroom. This is the first photo that we are going to be editing today, made by Rico. The first thing that I like to do with any photo that I am editing is to crop it. This is a very colorful photo, so I am going to bring the temperature up into the yellows. I am also bringing up the exposure because I feel like it's looking a little bit too dark. I always pull up the shadows and I am also going to pull the highlights down. I am adding a radial filter so I can brighten up only the face a little bit. I am going to add another radial filter with an invert effect so I can darken the edges. With this technique, the subject will be a little bit brighter, so when you are looking to the image, it will instantly attract the eyes to the subject. I am also going to add a tone curve. With the tone curve, I like to add a matte effect to my photos by pulling up the blacks and pulling down the shadows. This is how I am editing without changing the colors drastically. Now I will try the UNNiEDOLLS preset on this photo. I need to change some things to fit it to this picture. I am also removing the little rope from the right corner so nothing will disturb our eyes when we are looking to this image. And voila, here are the edits. The next image is from Dolly. I really like this image, however, it is not always easy to edit these types of images because there is a big contrast, especially if you don't shoot in RAW. After cropping, I am bringing up the exposure a bit and balancing out the tones. I am editing the colors a bit and adding some vignette. I am going back and forth to find the perfect settings. I am also going to brighten the face by adding a radial filter. This is my first edit without changing the colors drastically. Now I will add the UNNiEDOLLS preset to give a vintage, late summery effect to this image. After some adjustment, here are my final edits. The third image is a very good one by Sarah. It is not underexposed or overexposed, and the colors are also great. With my edit, I am going to enhance the subject, mostly by adding a little vignette and changing some colors a bit. I am also going to try a preset on this image. I use the UNNiEDOLLS again. After some changes, here are the before and afters. The next image was sent by Cindy. I don't need to crop this image, so I am starting with bringing up the exposure a bit. After it, I am pulling up the shadows and pulling the highlights down. I am adding texture and clarity to bring up some more details. As always, I am adding a vignette. I mean a double vignette by adding a radial filter as well to bring the attention to the subject. It is hard to fix the colors when I don't know exactly how everything is looking like in person, but I am trying my best to figure it out, and I hope you like my final edit of this photo. I am also trying a preset on this photo. Let's use the UNNiEDOLLS again. If you like how my presets are looking like, you can download them after subscribing to my newsletter. I leave the link in the description below, and please don't forget to share your edits with me. After some adjustment, here are my final edits. Sierra sent this photo to me. After cropping, I am going to bring the temperature down into the blues. I am also adjusting the tones. While I am editing the colors, I am trying to imagine how they would look like in person. I am adding radial filters to create a little vignette and brightening of the face. After creating the virtual copy of the edited image, I am going to add the UNNiEDOLLS preset. I need to edit the curve, the exposure and brighten up the face again, because the filter removes everything I added before. It is copying the settings from the preset to the raw image. These are my final edits. The next image was sent by Dolly. It is really hard to edit photos with a white background. Usually, the white is too warm or too cool, so I like to bring down the yellows or the blues. But first, I am bringing up the exposure, adding contrast, pulling down the highlights and pulling up the shadows. I am adding a radial filter to blur the edges of the photo a bit by pulling down the texture and the clarity. You can see the area that you are working on if you bring down the exposure. Don't forget to set it 0 again, because on a white background the vignette is not always looking good. None of my presets are looking good with white background, so here is my final edit. I hope you like it. The last photo is by Feather Dolls. As I said before, the first thing that I like to do with any photo that I am editing is to crop it. After cropping, I am balancing out the tones. After changing the temperature to create warmer colors, I am adding a radial filter. I change not only the exposure, but I am pulling down the texture and the clarity as well to create a little blur around the subject. I double this filter to double the effect, but I am changing the exposure and the size of the circle. My photo editing style is changing by time to time, by season to season. You probably noticed that my current presets are very moody, some have a bit warmer temperature, some have a bit cooler temperature. Don't forget that you can always change many settings and create your style, your own presets. these are the final photos. I hope you learned something new from my video. Thanks for watching. See you at the next one. Bye!